So it looks like I'm about to embark on an epic adventure, but I'm just going to TGIF to get some food. It's funny because as I'm leaving, I'm thinking about like in the jungle where if you're hungry and you need to get food, you don't really, it's not like you can go into the fridge or a cupboard and grab some like backup snacks or some, or some Cheez-Its or whatever. So you gotta go out and collect food. So we're in the situation in a hotel where we're stranded because of a snowstorm and you don't have any food, so I'm not gonna go out hunting, but I'm gonna go walk to TGIF to get some food. The reason why I'm walking is because I'm totally snowed in and my car can barely get it out of the driveway. So we'll see. It'll be fun. What's in the jungle, there is no like massive preparation, right? You just pick up and go. Grab your bow and arrow, plantain, and go out and get some food. Okay, we're here in Easton, Pennsylvania, and getting like 18 to 20 inches of snow, I don't know. But so far it's not bad. It's just when it starts getting really windy, that's when it sucks. But oh, we got the plow guy coming. I think it's beautiful, this white snow. And when my mom was here last year, we missed all this. I was kind of bummed out. I was really hoping she would be able to see this, but at the same time, she wasn't really too keen on how cold it was here. Straight. And the wind's blowing right into your face. That's not nice. It's actually really hard to see, so I probably should get to the side. Okay, I'm totally not prepared for this walk. So there's pretty much ice blowing right into my face. I'm gonna need, I should have brought snow goggles, but anyway, I'm already committed. And same thing in the jungle. If you're halfway through your hunting and you feel tired or whatever, what are you gonna do? Go back hungry? Same thing, I could go home now, but my kids probably won't be a little upset. I'm sure Shane would be upset because they're all hungry too. So I am nowhere near in the same kind of dangers and challenges of being in the Amazon. But it's, puts interesting perspective on things, you're more dedicated into acquiring food and the resources to survive. So pretty wild. And if you're not prepared, then you could have an unsuccessful hunt. So I'm clearly not prepared because I have snow and ice blowing straight into my eyes. I should have had goggles, but anyway, I'm committed. Let's go. Oh man, the snow and the ice and the highs hurt so bad. Obviously this isn't some anomaly or phenomenon for us living here in Pennsylvania, but what's cool is I could share this video with the Yanomami, and I can, when they see something amazing, they click their mouths out, and I can already hear it now. They're all completely amazed. The clicks of the tongue and the oohs and the ahs. They'll probably ask me, what am I doing? I can't say, I'm going to get some, I ordered some takeout from TGIF, obviously. So best thing I can tell them is that I went out to get food. That's all. So I can't wait to show this to mom and my family. Another thing that's on my mind as I do this kind of silly thing about walking to TGIF, but what happens if you get hurt, and I was just thinking about that. What if I slip and break an arm or get hit by a car or whatever, and there's actually a hospital right across the street, and calling emergency services, and probably won't
die or anything, but man, if you get hurt in the jungle, break an arm or suffer a laceration or accidentally get impaled, or we actually had a guy that, or you ran across a guy that got bit by a peccary, two puncture wounds, you know, in his upper, you know, in his upper arm. I'm here at TGIF. Got my food. So another major difference between getting food in the Amazon in here is that I could always stop and get a beer or two or a drink, you know. So yeah, kind of spoiled there, right? It changed from like sleet, you know, because when I came over here it was a lot of like sleet and ice kind of shooting into my eyes, and it was terrible. But now it's a beautiful, beautiful snowfall. Look at the size of these flakes, and this here, this general area. This is where I grew up. You know, this is actually, I moved to this neighborhood when I was, 12, 13 years old. So while mom was in the Amazon and, you know, kind of living life there, I was here in Easton, Pennsylvania. So this is my hometown. Quite a contrast, right? You know, mom's in the jungle and I'm here, you know, in the winter. So because I grew up here, I was educated here, I went to high school here and went to college here. And so, you know, I brought mom here, and because I really wanted to show her, like, this is my home. Like, this is where I lived. And, you know, all those years, 20 plus years of not seeing her and, or whatever. And kind of wanted to show her, like, hey mom, this is where I grew up and was raised as a child and as a boy and turned into a young man. And like, this is my urihi. Urihi means forest, you know, or jungle or whatever. And well, this is my urihi. This is my jungle. This is where I lived.
Kind of a juxtaposition between two crazy different worlds, right? The tropical heat and humidity to freezing cold and snow and winter storms here in Pennsylvania. And you know, to be frank, I'm grateful to know these two worlds.
Well, I made it back safe and sound. The foraging expedition was a success. We have our food, and there's my son. He's happy and that he is filling his belly with food. You know, if you have any questions or comments, anything you'd like to add to my insights or whatever, I'd love to hear about them. So let's keep this convo going. All right, thanks for watching.